Hello! Today I will go through DJI Go application for DJI Osmo Mobile 2 in great detail so you can get the most out of your smartphone gimbal. Before I start though, quick introduction. For those watching my channel first time, my name is Zdenka Karela and I'm a photographer slash former model slash lot of other things. You can watch tutorials, join mobile photography contest, or simply get entertained in my vlogs, which I will sometimes do as well. So don't hesitate to subscribe to my channel today. Let's move on. Well, I'm assuming you already downloaded and installed the DJI Go application. This app will allow you to use active track, Timelapse and pano functions. You can also configure camera and your gimbal settings. So let's turn it on. First and foremost, when you get a phone call and you will answer a call, gimbal will stop working for those who are wondering. Number one right here, we have connection status. Here you can see if your phone is connected with a gimbal, and all is working well. Number two, switch between camera and video. You just simply slide to change to make video or take photos, or you can just tap on, it will switch from video to camera and vice versa. Number three, we have photo and video modes. So let's look at the photo mode. So now we have to switch it here from video to photo. And here we have the photo modes. And as you can see here in photo mode, we have a choice of single photo, panorama, or long exposure. For length exposure, we have a choice of 2 seconds, 5 seconds, and 10 seconds. And there is also for single photo available HDR. Let's switch it from photo mode to video mode, and you have available auto, just regular mode, time-lapse, hyperlapse, or motion time-lapse. Time-lapse is the opposite of slow motion. You can record something like sunset over a long period of time, which is then play it in a short period of time. Here, you just select interval and duration. There will be another video I will create specifically about time-lapses, hyperlapses, and motion time-lapses, so I'm not going to get into detail here. Let's look further at this application. Hyperlapse has also interval and duration options. When you click on motion time lapse, you can select up to 5 different positions to create a moving time lapse. Simply click on the blue square, select the first position, move your gimbal, click on the blue square again to select second position, and so on. Now I'm using Android, so I don't have a slow motion available. It is only for iPhones. However, if you want to record a slow motion, you can just close this application. Just go to your regular camera application and here you can select slow motion. Your gimbal will work as well. Number four is shutter and record button. Tap to start or stop recording or taking photos. Number five is front and rear camera switch. If you tap it, you can switch between selfie mode and also regular rear camera. Number six is playback button, where you can see your photos or your videos. Number seven is metering mode and active track. When you click on metering mode, you can select autofocus and metering. Simply swipe up and down to adjust the exposure. If you tap and hold on the screen, you will lock the current exposure setting. To unlock, simply tap again. To use active track, simply tap on the object and track it as it moves. Right here. To exit, simply click right here. Number eight, here we have settings. Here you can reset camera, you can calibrate your gimbal and choose between slow, medium, and fast motor moves. Change your joystick direction and operation from left to right or up and down. You can set up a live stream to social media. Right here is number 9, which is gimbal preferences, where you can see scene mode. In sports mode, the smooth track is higher, and in a walk mode is lower. Pitch locks locks the tilt axis at the current angle when enabled. Right here is number 10, which is camera preferences. Here you can change your video resolution. Turn on your beautify mode if you like to. Change white balance or turn on or off flash. And also turn on grid if you like to use it. Number 11 is your home button. Number 12 is your flash status. Number 13 is your phone and gimbal battery level. And number 14 is your gimbal mode, whether it is follow or a free mode. To zoom, you can either use your button on gimbal right here on the side, or you can also use your two fingers on a screen. So when you put them together and then put them apart, you will zoom in. When you put those fingers close together, you will zoom out. Now you can use zooming only in mirroring mode. Editor, and you will get there by simply pressing home button is right here. So editor is for viewing, sharing, or editing your photos or videos. There are tools available to step up your results. Saved photo and videos can be uploaded to SkyPixel and shared on social media such as Facebook, Twitter, and others. SkyPixel right here is where you can see or share your photos or videos. Me button, which is right here, is if you already have its DJI account, then you can visit forum discussions there or online store. You can also tap recent button and go to reset the beginner guide to have tutorial launched next time you open the application and select a camera view. Well, that was the complete DJI Go application review. Feel free to like the video, share and comment below. Don't forget to subscribe for more DJI Osmo Mobile 2 videos and let me know if you would like to see any videos on a certain topic here. I'll see you next time again. Thank you for watching. Ciao. Ahoy.